Okay, moving on to section 5.4, counting. You only thought you knew how to count, right? You thought you learned that in kindergarten. Well, I'm going to teach you a different way of counting. Objective one is looking at counting the number of ways a sequence of operations can be performed. We're going to be using what's called the fundamental principle of counting. Let me read this to you and try to explain it as we go. If an operation can be performed in M ways, that's just a letter, let's say three ways, and a second operation can be performed in N ways, let's say five ways, then the total number of ways to perform a sequence of two operations would be the product, M times N, or in this case, 5 times 3. So we would say that there would be 15 ways that we could perform that operation. Does that make sense? M and N are just variables that wait for you to drop in some numbers. In this example problem, we're told that a certain make of an automobile is available in any of three colors, red, blue, or green, and comes with either a large or a small engine. In how many ways can a buyer choose a car? When you're using this counting technique, what I recommend you do is you actually write down blanks for each of the operations, and underneath the blanks, write in what it is that you're filling in. So we have a choice on color and on engine size. How many different choices do we have for the color of the car? Three. And how many choices do we have for the engine size? So that means that we have a total of 6 different car types. Have y'all been to Sonic and seen their advertisement that says we have over 600,000 different types of drinks? That's because they have the choice of either having diet or regular. What kind of flavor do you want? Do you want tea or soda, or, you know, all these different things? And those are all choices. So you choose your drink, tea or soda, then you choose what flavor of tea or soda, and then you choose diet or regular. And when you multiply all those different things together, that's how you come up with the 600,000 something choices that they have. Sounds impressive, but it's really not. Here's an example problem that deals with the fundamental principle of counting. License plates in a certain state contain 3 letters followed by 3 numbers. So I've got to have 3 letters followed by 3 numbers. So this is a letter followed by 3 numbers. How many choices do I have for the first letter on the license plate? 26. How many choices for the next letter? 26. Because nothing in the problem said that I couldn't let letters repeat, right? And then for the next letter, how many choices for the first number? 10. It has to be a single digit number, and we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's a total of 10 digits. So I have 10 here, here, and here. To get the total number of possible license plates, then, I would multiply these numbers together. And when you do that on your calculator, you're going to see that there's a total of 17,576,000 possible different license plates. Would this work in Texas, having 3 letters followed by 3 numbers for the license plates? Think about the license plate on your car. We have 4 numbers and 3 letters usually on a car. Unless you have a farm vehicle or a truck, they have a different letter number combination. Commercial vehicles have different combinations. The reason we had to do that is because we used to have just 3 letters and 3 numbers, but we've got more vehicles than that in Texas now. If we lived in a smaller state, this would be sufficient, but for Texas, not. So we had to add another digit to our license plates. Same thing with phone numbers. With phone numbers, there's a total of 10 digits, right? Used to, we didn't have to dial the area code on a phone number, so we just had a 7-digit phone number. We didn't have that many phone lines, but now everybody has a cell phone, and they use, like my husband has a work phone and a personal phone, and then tablets are, you know, if you've got a tablet on your plan, it's got a phone number associated with it. You know, we ran out of phone numbers, so we said, okay, we've got to start including the area codes. And big cities like Houston said, 713 just isn't cutting it anymore. So they added 2 other area codes for the city because there's just so many phone numbers in the area. So if you had the old original 713, I think you had to live inside the loop, and then they added the 281 outside, and then they added the 832 with cell phones and other things. So, you know, we've just had to increase the number of numbers. Objective 2 is counting the number of permutations. The word permutation is another word for ordering. We use permutation anytime order matters to us. When we count the number of permutations, we're counting the number of different ways that a group of items can be ordered. If we're going to use all of the items that are available to us, we use this symbol right here that's called a factorial. You only thought exclamation points belonged in English class, didn't you? Now you see that we use them in math, and it's a mathematical operation that means to multiply, start with a number, and it has to be a whole number, and then subtract one from that number and multiply going down. So for example, if I had 4 factorial, that would be equal to 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And that would be, 12 times 2 is 24. We can use our calculators to get this number. Let me write down the steps we're going to follow for the calculator. Your first step is to put the number on the home screen. Then you're going to hit Math, go over to Probability, go down to number 4, which is the exclamation point, and then hit Enter. And then I'll put the factorial symbol on your home screen, and then you hit Enter again to get your answer. So let's check this 4 factorial using our graphing calculator. Go ahead and get your calculator out. When I went to the new system, it made my calculator really weird. So we've got a really big display window. So following these steps, we would put 4 on our home screen. Then we hit Math, and that's this button right here. Go over to Probability, and then number 4 is the factorial, and I'm just going to hit 4 instead of entering. And then you hit Enter, and we see that we were right. 4 factorial is indeed 24. All right, let's use our calculator then to work some problems. Example 1 says 5 runners run a race. One of them will finish first, another second, so forth and so on. And how many different orders can they finish? So I've got 5 runners, and I want to know all 5 positions. Where do all 5 of them end up? If you wanted to use the counting principle, I would draw 5 blanks. Here's first place, second place, third place, fourth place, and then fifth place. How many choices do I have for who can come into first place? And then for second place? No, because one of them's already come in first, so now I've only got 4 to choose from. And then. So this would be 5 factorial. Let's find out what that is on our calculator. So we'd hit 5, Math, go over to Probability. Number 4 is factorial, hit Enter, and we get 120. Well, 5 times 24 is also 120, so you could check it that way. Factorials get really big really fast. They grow faster than exponential growth. I also illustrated that this formula we use for the number of permutations of n objects, when I use all of them, the multiplication principle for counting develops that formula for us, doesn't it? All right, in the next example, 10 runners run a race. The first place finisher will get a gold medal, the second place finisher will get a silver medal, and the third place finisher will get a bronze medal. And how many different ways can these medals be awarded? So I have gold, silver, and bronze. How many choices do I have for the gold medal? 10. Now the gold placement has been set. How many choices do I have for silver? And then how many do I have for bronze? 8. And this ends up being 9 times 8 is 70, 2 times 10 is 720. There's 720 different ways that I could award first, second, and third place out of a field with 10 runners. Now, I had to use the multiplication principle for counting here because I didn't use all 10 of the runners, so I couldn't just use the factorial. You can only use the factorial thing for permutations if you use all of the objects. What I've just found here is something that's called the permutation of R objects chosen from N. In this case, I had the permutation of 3 objects chosen from 10. I had a pool of 10 runners to choose from, but I've only selected 3. So in the last example, three runners were chosen from a group of 10, then ordered first, second, or third. This is referred to as a permutation of three items chosen from 10. In general, the permutation of R items chosen from N items is an ordering of the R items. It's obtained by choosing R items from a group of N items and then choosing an order for the R items. This is all a long, complicated, convoluted way of saying the way we do permutations when you're not using everything is this formula right here, where N represents your size of your sample and R represents the number that you're selecting out of that sample. N has always got to be first and it's always got to be the bigger number. You can only choose a few out of everything you have. You can't choose everything out of a few. The steps for doing this on your calculator, very similar to the factorial. You're first going to put a number for N on your home screen. Then you're going to hit Math, scroll over to Probabilities, and then down to, I think it's number 2. And then you're going to hit Enter, and then you're going to put in a number for R. And then you hit Enter, and it gives you your answer. So let's just double check this last example on our calculator where N is 10 and R is 3. We got 720, so let's go to our calculator. We put 10 on the home screen, hit Math, go over to Probability. Number 2 here is the permutation, and then we are selecting 3 at a time, and we did get 720, so it worked out. 10 selected 3 at a time was 720. That's what we got on our calculator, and we also verified it using the multiplication principle for counting. This formula is actually the formula with factorials on how you would calculate permutations. Do not worry about putting this formula on your formula sheet. We are just going to use this on the TI calculator. You don't have to worry about writing that on your formula sheet, because it's already pre-programmed in your calculators. Remember, we use permutation when order matters. It makes a difference when you're running a race if you come in first, second, or third. In this problem, we're told 5 lifeguards are available for duty one Saturday afternoon. There are 3 lifeguard stations. In how many ways can the 3 lifeguards be chosen and ordered among the stations? First of all, let's say the 3 stations we had the kiddie pool, the diving board, and then the regular pool. Would it make a difference to you if you worked at the kiddie pool or the diving board or the regular pool? If you were a lifeguard, it would matter to you. Probably don't want to watch the kiddie pool, or I don't know, maybe you do if you want to take it easy. I don't know. Anyway, so order matters there because you've got 3 different stations you could be at. We've got a total of 5 lifeguards, so N is equal to 5. R here will be 3 because I can only select 3 out of the 5. So on my calculator, what I want to find is 5 permuted 3 at a time. So I go to my calculator, and what do I have to hit first? 5, Math, Probability, 2, 3, Enter. And we see that that would be 60. You could verify it still using the counting rule for that first position, second position, and the third position. You would have 5 lifeguards to choose from for the first position, then 4, and then 3. So that's 20 times 3 is 60. It works out. I prefer using the calculator and the formula that's already built into your calculator. But if all else fails, you can draw your blanks for your operations and then look at the number of choices you have for each, and it will work as well. Objective 3 is counting the number of combinations. Combinations is what we use when order doesn't matter. Let's say that you're looking at the lifeguard thing. You don't care where you work, it just matters to you if you work, right? You don't care if you're working at the kiddie pool, the diving board, or the regular pool. You just want to be called into work because you need money. There, the order wouldn't matter to you. So in that last example, I would use 5 combined 3 at a time. That's combinations, and that's the button on our calculator that was right under permutations. And do you expect this to be more or less? Let's check. So we hit 5, Math, Probability. Combinations is the one right under permutations. It's number 3. and we're still choosing 3. Less. It doesn't matter which pool you're working at, you just want to work, so it'd be less. The number of combinations can be found using this formula, or it can be found using the TI calculator, and it's all underneath the math probability. You just go down to 3 instead of 2. So I'm not writing these steps down. If you want to go back and modify your notes here, number 3 would be combinations. I would just go back and make that change to your notes for the steps for the TI calculator. Math probability, go down then to combinations instead of permutations. The steps to get there are exactly the same. In this example problem, we're told that at a certain event, 30 people attended and 5 will be chosen at random to receive a prize. The prizes are all the same, so the order in which you're drawn doesn't matter. Since the order doesn't matter because you're either picked or you're not. That's all you care about. You don't care if you're picked first, second, third, or fifth because all 5 prizes are the same. So the order doesn't matter. And that's the first thing you want to ask yourself whenever you encounter these problems. Does the order matter? If it does, use permutations. If it doesn't, use combinations. Then you've got to decide what is your sample size and how many are you selecting. For this problem, what would our sample size be? 30. We have 30 people in attendance. How many are we selecting? 5. So on your calculator, what you want to do is 30, choose 5. So we go to our calculator and we type in 30, math, go over to probability. Number 3 is combinations, but we're choosing 5. And we hit enter and we see that there's 142,506 different ways that this could happen, that you could award prizes. 142,000, what did I say? 506. Here are the steps in case you forget how to get to the screen with the TI-84 Plus. This is the commands that you would use, but you have to remember to put the number for N on the home screen first. Now here's an example problem where counting definitely helps us. A box of light bulbs contains 8 good light bulbs and 2 burned out light bulbs. 4 bulbs will be selected at random to put into a new lamp. What is the probability that all 4 bulbs are good? So our event here would be all 4 bulbs good. And you remember me telling you the formula, the probability of an event is the number of ways in which that event can occur divided by the number of elements in your sample space. Do y'all remember that? The number of ways in which I can select all 4 good bulbs is I could take 4 out of the, how many good bulbs were there? 8 good bulbs, and does it matter which order I choose them in? No, I just care if I've selected a good bulb or not. So I can select 4 out of 8 good bulbs. My sample space, though, is all 10 bulbs and all the different ways I can choose 4 out of the 10 bulbs. So go to your calculator and do 8 choose 4 and tell me what you get. I'm not doing it. You do it on your calculator and we'll check our answers. Now go to your calculator and find out what 10 choose 4 is. This is all of the bulbs. So putting these pieces together, and I always said identify what your event is in words, find the number of ways that you can get your event, and then the number of ways you can get your sample space. So the probability of my event will be equal to 70 divided by 210, which is 1/3. And this wraps up counting with permutations and combinations. Remember, N has got to be bigger than R.